President-elect says it's 1,100 jobs. What is the latest, though, that you're hearing in terms of the jobs saved at your plant?
Yeah, you know, Mr. President-elect Trump came in and said it was 1,100 jobs. We find out, sat with a company day before yesterday, and we find out it's actually only 750 actually union production jobs that will be staying. So Trump kind of added in the 400 R&D and engineering jobs that were already slated to stay. So we're kind of disappointed that we're losing 550 actual union jobs.
You shook his hand, and before we even came on, you said that was pretty cool. You got to shake the president-elect's hand. But
right.
Disappointing, though, that the numbers are off.
Right.
The union president said that the president-elect lied his ass off, is how he put it, about
right.
how this deal is looking for the workers.
Right.
Do you feel lied to?
Well, in a way, we do. I mean, we do. I mean, we feel like, you know, we thought you're going to save all the jobs. I mean, we've got 1,400 people at this facility, union, you know, factory, regular jobs, and we, you know, he didn't say anything about the 400 that were already going to stay. So, you know, it kind of seems like it was a, you know, a dog and pony show, and we were happy that, no doubt, that some jobs are saved, but we're disappointed that we're still losing a lot of workers.
I think what is most important here is to hear your voice. We heard from the president-elect a lot. Through the
right.
campaign, talking about Carrier and the vice president-elect. But it seems to me, as you sit here now, you seem to be a little conflicted about the deal,
right.
conflicted about how it all went down. How are you feeling?
A lot of confusion. You know, we were also confused when he was talking about, you know, I wasn't really, when I was talking about saving Carrier jobs, I wasn't talking about this facility. I was just talking about Carrier as a whole in the country. So we were like, yeah, but you use Carrier, you know, as your platform for
you
jobs.
You really thought he meant Carrier.
Yeah, we literally thought you meant us. And then that's why, you know, a lot of us, and myself and other leaders in the union, we called Trump out on it and said, you know, if you're going to run on this, use these workers as your platform. We're going to hold you accountable to it. And that's what we did.
But at the same time, you're very thankful you have your job today. Then 800 people at Carrier
right.
will have their jobs
right.
where they didn't.
Right.
That seems, that's, you know, that's a that's conflicting.
Right. Yeah, and like I said, I'm happy for myself and the ones that are going to be able to stay. But I've had a lot, I'm going to be losing a lot of friends there. And,
mm-hmm.
you know, you got to be in their shoes. They're, you know, you have the president come in saying the jobs are being saved, but these people aren't, their jobs aren't being saved.
TJ, did you support the president? Did you support Donald Trump in the election? I ask because I wonder if this experience has changed your opinion of the president-elect.
No, I was not a big supporter of Trump. I didn't vote for him. I didn't know how to take the guy. I still don't know how to take the guy. I give him all the respect for being able to make this deal happen. And
mm-hmm.
I mean, because this is unprecedented to see this. And I'm happy that a lot of these jobs are staying. And I'm hopeful that he continues the promises he's made of keeping American jobs here and threatening these companies that are wanting to leave. So that's all we can do right now is hope for the best that he follows through on these other promises he made.
When you talk about hope, you have your job now. How confident are you about your future?
Well, as to Carrier, you know, I'm definitely thankful I have my job for the future. You know, the details of the deal, we don't know if, you know, Carrier decides to leave after Trump if he's not reelected. So, you know, the company through UTC, our parent company, offers, you know, employee scholar program where you go back to school and they reimburse you. We have all other opportunities. You know, I've currently been working with a company called WorkingNation, and they've kind of opened this discussion up about jobs and the future.
So you're not banking on Carrier. You're looking for other avenues now.
Well, I'm going to go back to school.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to take advantage of the employee scholar program, and I'm going to stay at Carrier and continue to go to work every day and do my job. And but you know, at the same time, I want to get education and have that in my back pocket in case, you know, Carrier decides to jump up and leave 3-4 years.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, as Greg Hayes had an interview with the CEO of UTC a few days ago, and Trump mentioned the $16 million investment in our facility. In the future, and we found out Greg Hayes said all that $16 million is going to go towards his automation, which is going to actually cost jobs.
Which is a much bigger part of the
conversation
about where jobs are going in the manufacturing industry, and a bigger conversation that we all need to be having in this country.
Absolutely.
It's great to meet you, TJ. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you for having me.